So there was really no effort to call AMLC because you said hindi naman yung ginagawa. There was no effort to call the Bank of Bangladesh either. At best, you asked the branch manager and the branch manager vouched for the accounts. Although, kinokontest rin nila yon na meron daw tumawag.
And at that time, Your Honor, the funds were already out of the four accounts.
Okay. The account, the money is in the William Goh account transferring to PhilRem. Wala rin kayong magagawa nun kahit may request for recall na?
No. The law and the regulations do not give us that authority.
Okay, I'm going to ask BSP later about this. No? Pagkatapos, nilabas ng PhilRem a large amount of money, binalik rin sa RCBC to convert. At that moment, hindi nyo rin pwedeng i-hold yung pera. Kasi di ba, pumasok na sa PhilRem and then kinonvert ninyo sa RCBC. That's right, no, Ms. Salud, no?
Your Honor, we are not allowed to hold or freeze. We do not have the authority to hold or freeze. After it's moving down, we do not have that authority, Your Honor.
So the only time, your testimony is, the only time that you could have was when the money was remitted to the four accounts or from the time that the four accounts moved to William Goh or from the time that the William Goh account moved to PhilRem or from the time that PhilRem converted back to RCBC. At what point could you have done something?
Only in the four accounts, Your Honor. We are a private institution. The laws and regulations do not give us that authority. In fact, when we receive a freeze order, for example, excluding some accounts, we still have to ask for guidance from the regulators. Why are these accounts not included? And
in this
they will
case,
guide us.
You didn't ask guidance from the regulators, from BSP or AMLC.
After the freeze order was issued, Your Honor, I believe we did send a letter to the AMLC asking for
guidance. After a certain number of days.
Yes, but in this case, in the start, we just filed our suspicious transactions reports as we normally do, okay. Your Honor.